A Mouheneenner woman from Tasmania has teamed up with American health experts to address Indigenous trauma. Professor Debra Hocking will roll out an Indigenous trauma recovery course at the University of Wollongong. It's the first program of its kind to be offered in Australia. NITV's Tara Callinan spoke with Professor Hocking today.
A program adapted from Harvard University's medical school in the United States is being rolled out on Australian shores.
Some of the guys from Harvard had come out to Australia and visited Aboriginal communities in the Northern Territory and New South Wales, and straight away identified the trauma, because they're experts, they're world experts in trauma, could clearly see that we had community in crisis.
University of Wollongong Professor Debra Hocking will coordinate the new program, which she describes as a trauma toolkit for health professionals,
which will deepen their understanding and knowledge of the incidence of trauma. So we have an evidence base for it now. So, and a lot of our mental health workers are saying to us, you know, we're not equipped, we can't deal with it, we need further training. So that identified to me that that was completely the right thing to do.
The Indigenous Trauma Recovery Program will specifically address the alarming rates of family violence and abuse in Aboriginal communities, factors which Professor Hocking says lead to compound trauma,
which is layers of trauma going from right from colonisation to the loss of land, to the loss of culture, language, family. How long's a piece of string?
Last week, Professor Hocking finalised the curriculum with the help of key Indigenous health experts.
We had Professor Judy Atkinson, we had Dr. Nyree Brown, we had Graham G, an Aboriginal psychologist from Melbourne, Joanne Buckskin from Wollongong.
The program opened for enrolment online last night and is already attracting widespread interest.
I have had interest from Papua New Guinea and other countries overseas.
The program will formally begin in July. Tara Callinan, NITV News.